So, Professor, tell us a little bit about the keynote oration you just gave.
Well, it was an enormous honor and pleasure to give the oration. I'm a dermatologist in Oxford. I see patients with inflammatory skin diseases such as atopic dermatitis, food allergy, and also chronic spontaneous urticaria. And I also run a lab in Oxford where we try and understand mechanisms of skin disease, really to try and identify new approaches to treat patients. We're just entering a phase of incredibly exciting times for new treatments emerging, particularly for atopic dermatitis. And that new wave of therapeutics has really come from an understanding of the pathogenesis. And we hope to be able to contribute to that understanding. What I was talking about specifically was the identification of a population of immune cells which have been missed by the immunology community for many years. And they've really exploded onto the scene, and there's now a lot of interest in these cells, not only in the skin, but also other sites of the body as well. But the skin seems to be a particular site and focus of interest. They're lymphocytes, so they're very similar to T cells, but not T cells, not B cells, they're not natural killer cells, which are other lymphocytes. But they're termed innate lymphoid cells. And they have a number of different forms that have different functions. And we think a particular subtype called innate lymphoid cell type 2 is important in the pathogenesis of atopic dermatitis. So what I was describing is that we can find the cells in the lesions. We're trying to understand how they're functioning, what they're responding to, what they're doing in response to those triggers, and ultimately how they might be playing a role in disease and how we might be able to help by therapeutically manipulating them in some way. And so I gave the example that the cells produce a family of cytokines or inflammatory mediators called type 2 cytokines. So these include IL-4, 5 and 13. And one of the first therapeutics which targets this pathway specifically is dupilumab, which targets the IL-4 receptor, which is important for IL-4 and IL-13 signaling. And as has been discussed by others very eloquently during the course of this meeting, dupilumab is showing fantastic benefit in patients. Others have talked about the broader benefits and the adverse events associated with dupilumab, but nevertheless it's been a landmark change in terms of options for our patients, and that's only going to increase. One point I would like to make though is it's really important for us to maximise and optimise use of our existing treatments, particularly topical approaches, because if they're used well and appropriately, they're very cost effective, they can actually hold to a certain level of disease, and it's important for scarce NHS resources that we use existing treatments optimally. But if in those patients existing treatments are failing, then dupilumab and other emerging approaches will be enormously beneficial.
So I know one of the kind of overarching themes of your lecture, one of the things that you said was it's an exciting time for atopic dermatitis. Mm. So are these the sort of things that you were alluding to, I guess, in why it's so exciting area for research?
It is, because finally we've got the technologies to understand the disease mechanisms, and we're now entering this wave of new therapeutics, so we're finally going to have new options for our patients, and ultimately that's what we're wanting to do, is to improve therapeutic options for our patients. And the landscape, the treatment landscape, I'm sure in a few years' time will be very different to what we've got now, ultimately giving more options to our patients. And hopefully we can use appropriate treatments in appropriate patients and give patient benefit. There was a couple of things I would like to add, if I may, from that. One is, one important aspect of these new therapies is making sure that we're using them well and using them appropriately.
Sure.
And an important initiative, which is a BAD, British Association of Dermatologists initiative, also received funding from the British Skin Foundation, is the ASTAR registry. This is a UK and Ireland registry of patients, paediatric and adult patients, who are going to be monitored longitudinally on existing treatments, but also some of the new treatments. And it's through that wealth of information that will come from across the country and Ireland that will be able to understand how to best use these novel approaches, and we'll understand more about disease pathogenesis for the next wave of new therapeutic advances. So the BSF and the BAD are playing an important role in this very key national initiative, and as well as their own funding and grant funding programs that are funding others. And I'd also like to say, if I may, that the BAD and the BSF have funded me during early stages in my career, which have been extraordinarily important to allow me to generate data, to apply for larger grants from national organisations such as MRC and the Wellcome Trust, and these have provided opportunities. The BSF funding has provided opportunities to successfully apply for those grants.
Wonderful. And then one final question: with your exciting research, how close are you to translating that into therapeutic?
Yeah. Well, there's a lot going on. So dupilumab has recently been approved, so we're using that. We're involved, as is at many other centres in the UK, in many other clinical trials that are going on for atopic dermatitis, new approaches for the treatment of atopic dermatitis. And you know, they're over the coming years, some of those will start to be approved and will be used. So I think we're just at the start of an exciting time, but I think there's much more to be done, and there'll be further benefits for our patients within that.
Perfect. Thank you very much. Thanks.
Thank you.
Good. Thank you.